At the entrance to the runner, only part of available energy of water is converted into kinetic energy, and sustainable part is in the form of pressure energy. The pressure energy at inlet is much higher than pressure at outlet. The pressure difference between inlet and outlet of runner is called reaction pressure, and hence the turbine are called reaction turbine. The old Francis turbine were purely radial flow runner. That means the water flow inwardly following the periphery of bucket in radial direction, in and out, and used for medium scale hydropower plant. The flow from center to outward through bucket is known as outward flow radial turbine, but not used because of turbine rails. Hence, we use inward flow turbine. The turbine which is mostly used today is modern Francis turbine, which is known as inward mixed flow turbine, which means water enters towards the center in radial direction and discharges out of a runner axially. The turbine is just a mixing of impulse and reaction turbine. The only difference in his amazing design of blades, the blades rotate using both reaction and impulse force of water flowing through them. The ability to use both the kinetic and potential energy to produce power, hence is known as mixed flow turbine, and is the best modern turbine widely used in hydropower plant. This turbine is used where there is a need of medium head, medium discharge, and medium specific speed. The head range is in between 40 to 600 meters, but delivers its best performance between 100 to 300 meters. Following are the other specification of turbine as power range, specific speed, efficiency, and flow rate. Francis turbine are heavyweight turbine and largest plant are situated in Brazil and China, generating capacity of 700 megawatt each. The figure shows the construction of Francis turbine and its components. The main components of Francis turbine are scroll casing, guide vanes, which is also known as wicket gates, runner bed, and draft tube. Further, we will discuss the parts in detail. First, penstock. The penstock is used as a diameter. Penstock is a pipe carrying water from head gate to water well. The penstock used in Francis turbine has a diameter ranging from 0.91 to 10 meters. It is an enclosed pipe that delivers water to turbine system and also controls the water flow. The material used to manufacture penstock are steel, usually for high head penstock, while for low head, plastic, concrete, mild steel is also used. The next important component is spiral or scroll casing. The water from penstock flows into outer scroll casing of turbine, which is made up of spiral shape. The casing surrounds the guide vanes and the runner in the shaft. The casing and the runner always run full of water, and the cross section of casing is made up of decreasing area, so the water is eventually distributed around the circumference of runner at constant velocity and pressure. The material used for casing is casing of reaction turbine depends upon the head it walks. The casing is made up of concrete for less than 30 meter head, while for 100 meter it is made from welded rolled steel plates, and for more than 100 meter head they are made up of cast iron. Stay vanes are provided inside the casing to support in the large units of turbine, and they also help in guiding the water from casing to guiding well so that water is equally distributed around the periphery without formation of any eddy to avoid loss of efficiency. The casing also have numerous openings. The openings are here. Opening. The casing has numerous openings throughout the length at regular intervals to allow the water to strike on the blade of runner. The opening convert pressure energy of fluid into kinetic energy just before water strikes on the blade, and also maintains contact constant velocity of fluid. This is how the spiral casing looks. Third important component is about the guide mechanism. It consists of stationary ring in a form of wheel called as guide wheel. It surrounds the outer periphery of runner and is fixed to inner surface of casing. In between the outer and inner ring of guide wheel, there is a series of guide vanes, or also known as wicket gates, of aerofoil section present. This gate forms number of passes between casing and runner blades. These are the wicket gates, also known as guide vanes. These vanes are fixed in position, but they cannot rotate around their they can rotate around their respective pivots. The function of guide vanes is to direct the water from casing to moving vanes of runner without shock at inlet. Hence, to achieve smooth and shockless entry to the runner, the velocity of water must be kept tangent to the inlet velocity, inlet tip of runner. Guide vanes also regulate the discharge according to the load acting on the turbine. It can also be done by swinging the guide vanes about their own pivot by opening or closing the guide vanes passage. Swinging action of a guide vanes are obtained by regulating rod connected to regulating shaft and is operated by servo motor governing mechanism. Material used to manufacture wicket gates are structural steel and stainless steel. Now, runner and runner blades. The runner is connected to the main shaft of turbine. The shaft may be horizontal or vertical, and accordingly it is known as horizontal turbine or vertical turbine. The shaft is made up of steel and is supported in thrust bearings. The runner consists of suitable design blades of aerofoil sections so that water enters and leaves the blade without shock. Number of blade usually used is on the runner is 16 to 24, and when the number of blades are more, the water in contact with the blades, hence there is more friction loss, and if a blades are less, there will be more loading on the blade, hence the number of blades used are around 16 to 24. The blade of Francis turbine is designed in such a way that one portion of a blade design such that one portion of a blade design creates the pressure difference between opposite faces of blade when the water flows through it, and remaining portion of a blade design use impulse force of water hitting it, and this combined action of pressure difference and impulse force generate enough power to turbine moving at required speed. Hence, there is a decrease in both kinetic energy and potential pressure energy of water at exit. Therefore, this design used for the both reaction as well as impulse force to generate power output. And this is better than individual impulse and reaction turbine could produce at same water head conditions. The runner are made up of cast iron for low head and stainless steel for high head turbines. The last one is the draft tube. It is an integral part of any reaction turbine. Water passing over the blade is discharged to the tail rest through a gradual increasing area called draft tube. The small end of a draft tube is fixed to the outer opening of a casing, and its bigger end is deeply submerged in a tail rest at least 1 meter depth from tail rest level. Since it can be noted that the entire passage of reaction turbine from headrest to tail rest are totally enclosed and does not communicate with atmosphere, it is necessary since reaction turbine run under pressure. The function of draft tube are: it converts kinetic energy of water at exit of runner into useful pressure energy, and water discharges into tail rest at very low velocity, hence increases the pressure head. It draft tube also improves the efficiency of turbine. This is how the draft tube works. There are different types of draft tube, named as straight diversion tube, Moody Bell's mounted draft tube, Moody separating tube or hydra cone, simple elbow tube, elbow with circular inlet and rectangular outlet. This is the setup of Francis turbine, showing the working of turbine from headrest to the tailrest. Here are some advantages of Francis turbine. Francis turbine control is easy to control with variable heads, and very little changes in efficiency with respect to time is shown, and size of runner is small. Mixed flow turbine is also used in irrigation water pumping set to pump water from ground for irrigation. These advantages are: inspection is relatively difficult, and problem of cavitation occurs when difference in pressure of water entering the turbine and exits after striking is too high. Due to this, the pressure difference, the air molecules which are relatively at high pressure and the water coming out enters the turbine casing in a form of bubbles. These bubbles keep exploding near the surface of runner blades, causing shock waves, which causes defect near the surface of runner blade, called as cavitation, which decreases the efficiency of turbine and also creates noise and vibration. To prevent cavitation, we can use material like stainless steel, or also we can surface hardening of blades can be done. And cost is high. These are the other disadvantages mentioned. Maintenance is also difficult due to the complexity in the design, and also the cost is high. These are some of the recent advancements. New type of design are developed to reduce the cost as well as the complexity in the mechanism. And modified turbine are used, such as cross flow turbine. And also a new turbine requires less space, and cost is also less, and less moving parts. Applications. It is one of the most efficient hydro turbine, and it works on wide range of head and flow rate, and is one of the most widely used turbine used to generate the electricity. In addition to this, it is also used in pump storage systems for irrigation purpose. And places where Francis turbine is currently used is in China for the Three George Dam, and also in Brazil and the mentioned places. Conclusion. From 1848 to the present, countless wheelwrights, inventors, and engineers have contributed to improving the performance of hydro turbines. As a result of their effort, It is now possible to achieve over 95% efficiency. The modern Francis turbine is most widely used turbine designed today, particularly for medium head and large flow rate situations. Okay, thank you. Any questions?